Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Jake Homerman Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. Jake is in the 2018 season. We're in the month of May here and trying to get things going in the right direction for the Tampa Bay Rays, who are not really playing up to where they want to be right now. Jake is doing quite well himself, though. 10-game hitting streak that he is currently on. However, we're 17-25 as a team, so we've got to pick that up for the Rays if they want to have any hopes of competing this year. That is a shot right back up the middle. Pitcher kind of ducks for his life, and that's going to extend his hitting streak to 11 games now. He's no Skeeter Rabbit. He's got a long way to go to have that kind of epic hitting streak, but you got to start somewhere. 11 games, not bad for the youngster. So Tampa up 2-0, and oh, right back up the middle. Another bullet shot ricocheting off the mound and into center field. However, that ball was hit a little too hard for that guy to try to score. He's thrown out at the plate, so no RBI, just a hit. And Jake is 2-for-2 in this game. That's 3-2 Tampa at this point when he's going to range towards the second base bag and throw a strong throw to first base to end an inning with the Rays in the lead. Still 3-2, and it's the top of the fourth. Yeah, fourth inning, and he's already got two hits. Not too bad. He's got an 0-1 count with two outs, and why don't you make it three hits? Three sharp singles to center field, and Jake is dialed in here in Texas. Looking really comfortable at the plate, looking like his swing is right on. So Texas comes back and ties this 3-3, and looks like they're going to get him out for the first time. Or are they? The throw skips, and Prince Fielder is not able to field this one cleanly. He's on base, not with a hit, but with an error, and now he's trying to steal second base. That's a strikeout, but they will not throw him out at second. Stolen base for Jake Homerman, and he's in scoring position. Wants to be that go-ahead run. Not going to happen right there because strike three swinging ends the inning. Tampa would eventually grab the lead 4-3, and here in the top of the ninth, we get another chance. 3-2 count, and very patient right there. Takes ball four and will take his base. So Homerman sees six pitches in that at-bat and frustrates the pitcher a little bit. 2-2 count now, and he's taking off. That ball is hit deep to left. Will it be caught? No chance. It's in the seats. Two-run bomb, and the Rays look like they're in position to win this ball game as Segura goes deep, 359 feet to left field. Replay, please. Yeah, here we go. Nice swing pulling that pitch and getting it over the high wall in left field right down the line. It's going to add up to a Tampa Bay 6-4 victory. They'll take it. They'll gladly take it as they're starving for wins here early in the season. So a 6-4 win in the books, and the first game of the series goes to the Rays. Let's see what they can do in the second game against Francisco Liriano, as you got a pair of second basemen highlighted in the pregame right here, including Jake Homerman. Let's see what he does today. Following up a three-hit game, he's hit safely in 11 games. Oh, make that 12 games. He deposits that one out to the center field grass and is on yet again. 12 straight games, a dozen there for Jake Homerman and counting, as you see the graphic right there. Nice job continuing to get on base at least once every day. This is a high fly ball that is not going to get him on base. It's going to be, whoa, a little bit of an adventure out there, but he does eventually make the catch, and the inning is over. It's 6-1 Texas right now. That's not going well, and he gets under this. Jake pops this up high on the infield. When it comes down near the mound, it is caught, and Jake Homerman is out again. He goes 1-for-4 in the 7-1 loss. Francisco Liriano wins his fifth game of the season. Matt Moore 2-4 after that loss. So we've split the first two games of the series. Let's get out there and try to take it to Cole Hamels and get a series victory. Again, need all the wins we can get right now at 18-26, slipping further behind as we are in last place in the division. It wasn't that long ago that we were sitting atop the division with a game or two lead. But it's been a struggle since that point. Yeah, not a struggle for Jake Homerman to get another hit and extend his hitting streak. He does it early on, and we're now at 13 games. All right, throwback power with the unis here comes in handy for him as he's able to get that hit early. And how about a steal of base while you're out there? He's going to do that as well. picks his spot to run, and it works out for him. So with a 2-1 count and one out, this ball is hit to left, and it's over. The left fielder's head, he kind of hesitated to make sure it wouldn't be caught, and then he goes ahead and scampers to home plate to score the run. Nice base running right there, making sure he doesn't get caught off, but still being able to score. But it's 3-2 right now, Tampa in the lead. Chance for a double play ball. We haven't seen one yet in this episode. Yes, he's out at first, and they do complete the double play, continuing to lead 3-2 into the top of the fifth inning. And that ball's hit hard, but right at the shortstop, and that throw is going to get him at first base. So he's got his one hit, but will that be all in this game? 4-3, chance to sacrifice right here. This is kind of funny. The in-game broadcaster said I had to get him over to second base at any cost, so I get the sacrifice down, and what do I get? One training point. Apparently the training logic and the commentary were not seen eye to eye on that situation. There is a grounder to first base, and Prince Fielder gets the out himself. Oh, we got an 8-8 game. Texas has rallied. We had them where we wanted them for a while there. I think it was like 8-3, but now they've come all the way back. But we've got the bases loaded and a big chance to break the tie again. Not going to happen. Fly out to center field, and Jake is retired. Have a bad feeling about this. Well, we still have a chance to play on. That's the winning run going over to third base. We get the out at first, but they've got a chance to win this thing. Will they do it? Yes. Texas wins 9-8. Jake goes 1-for-7. He got that hit in his first trip, I believe, right? First or second trip, and nothing after. 1-for-7. Frustrating day for him as a whole as they take the loss and lose 2 out of 3 games in Texas. So now we head northwest to the state of Washington, Seattle to be exact. Safeco Field, beautiful place. Never been there, but would love to be someday. This ball is hit deep to center field, but right there at the wall in left center, the catch is made. A bid for a home run, but yeah, not enough on it right there. Not enough mustard. 1-1 game in the fourth, and that was hit hard. As a matter of fact, that took a nasty hop. And what's the ruling going to be here? If it's hit, he's extended his hitting streak. And yeah, they say base hit. So he's able to get one off of King Felix here and extend the hitting streak to 14 straight games. We got a 2-2 game in the sixth inning. Runner on first. That's right between the legs of Felix and into center field. His second hit. Not bad. Not bad at all. We got runners at first and second now. Will anything come of it? No. Still tied 2-2 in the ninth. Felix Hernandez out of the game, but it doesn't matter. Result is the same. Base hit to center field. Jake's got a 3-hit game. Okay. Now, can they get him around? He's happy. Look at that. Fist pump in the air, clapping. But in the end, it'd be the Mariners fans doing the cheering as they win the game 5-4. How did we blow it? We blew it again. 3-for-5 is Jake Homerman, but it doesn't matter. We lost. Jake's career stats popped up here, so I thought I would pass those along if you just want to kind of do the series reset here and to see where we stand at this very moment. And where we stand is in the midst of a 3-game losing streak. Youch. Okay, well, let's try to go get one today and get back in the win column. We need it. We need it badly. First inning. Good chance here. Runners at the corners and one out. Can he come through? That's through for a base hit. Yes, he does get an RBI single. He's hitting 15 straight games. That throw was terrible, but luckily backed up by the pitcher. Or we would have moved up extra bases. Anyway, there you go. Jake Homerman, 15 straight games. He's got a long way to go, like I said, to catch Skeeter Rabbit, Jack Hammer, those guys. Oh, yeah, Joe DiMaggio, since he's got the real record in baseball in real life. Anyway, whoa, crashing into the wall and stealing an extra base hit away from Jake right here. Let's watch it again in super slow-mo. He gets back there, and great catch, patting himself as he hits the wall eventually. Roll tape, roll tape. Okay, finally, there you go, bracing himself for impact. That's a great catch, and it keeps Jake Homerman off the base paths with what would have been at least a double. Nope, not that time. 2-1 Seattle in the ninth. 0-2 count. That pitch actually hit him in the foot? Really? Wow, okay. Interesting. That's a breaking pitch that just keeps breaking, and you see he checks his swing, and it grazes him, so he'll take first base. He could be that tying run. Let's bring him around. Need a big hit here. Find a gap. This ball down the left field line in foul territory. And oh my goodness! He did like a full Superman leap to make that catch. That might be candidate for catch of the year. Can I see that again? Please? Pretty please? Okay, great. Look at this. Oh my. Get that man a cape. He just flew through the air and robbed him. That's got to be catch of the year candidate right there. Wow. Anyway, this game's not quite over yet. Well, maybe now it's over. Fly ball. Very high to center field, but it is going to be caught, and that is your ball game. So they strand Homerman out on the base pass, and Seattle gets the victory. What is that? Four straight losses now, I believe, for the Tampa Bay Rays. They just cannot muster enough offense to win the game. So there's your 15-game hitting streak for Jake Homerman. That's a positive, right? We got personal goals being met, even if the team isn't meeting their goals. We're 11 games below 500 right now. Youch. Anyway, signing some autographs before the game. Everybody's taking notice to this youngster as he progresses early on in his career. You see, Seattle is a game below 500 as well, but obviously much closer than we are to that mark. So in the first inning, trying to extend this hitting streak and get the team a victory all in one. That's not going to do it. That's a ground out. 1-0 Seattle in the fourth. Got a chance for an R1 play here. That if we can make the diving play, and can we make the throw too? Yep, there you go. Solid play at second base. Taking away a hit. Thank you, Jake. All right, let's get back to the plate here. Fifth inning. Still looking to extend that hitting streak. That's not going to do it. Pop-up foul territory. Plenty of room for the catcher to make the play. Jake Homerman is retired. We're running out of chances here to extend that streak. Tampa up 6-4 in the eighth. This could be the last chance. He hits it well. Opposite field. Get over his head. No, he gets back there and makes a catch. Shoot. Thought maybe for a second he would get the hit right there, but he does not. The hit streak ends at 15 games. He will not be chasing Skeeter Rabbit, Jackhammer, or Joe DiMaggio anytime soon, as he'll have to start over here. But they do get the win, so I guess that's positive, right? Yeah. Now we're just 10 games below 500. Got to do something about that. Got to catch fire here and get back in the division, as we are already trailing way behind 8.5 games. Anyway, we'll see you next time for more Jake Homerman.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.